Hi my beautiful friends, welcome to my channel. I am Srijita, your tarot reader, and today in this video I'm going to tell you all about the question is, you know, is he good for me or bad, or is she good for me or bad? So this is a kind of a general reading, and in this video I'm going to tell you that a person that you are thinking about, is he or she is good for you or not. So this is going to be a super general reading. Here I got two piles, pile number one the owl and pile number two the council. Okay, I choose these two cards as pile main card because the owl is all about knowledge. That is all about seeing the unseen, because this is the only bird in the world that can see at dark, right? So the owl and the council is all about this card. The council is all about a person who is really thinking about their higher self, always knocking over the supernatural power to get help. So owl is basically guided by knowledge, and the council is basically guided by their instinct gut. So very rational and very intuitive. So I got these two piles. So please choose any one pile, specifically any one pile, to get your specific answer. And mind that, guys, this is a general reading. Thank you, and choose any one pile. Pile number one, the owl, and pile number two, that council. You may pause the video here. Hi my angels, if you choose pile number one, that is owl, that is all about, you know, guided to knowledge, guided to ancestral guidance, this is your pile. So I'm gonna use my handmade cards because I was thinking about using my own energy to pick up your energies. Okay, so let's see. Please angels, tell me, pile number one, those of you choose pile number one, is he or she is good for them or not? If he or she is good for them or not, whatever the person is they good for, is, are they good for them or not? Please tell me, please tell me, angels, tell me. Okay, so I got the first card, that is death. Okay, so don't be afraid, guys. The death card is really telling me that, you know, a transformation. I'm sensing that the person you are asking about, that person is really a transformed one. In the past, the person was not the same as they are right now in the present time. Or some of you may be experiencing a person that has really changed their behavior, really changed their lifestyle only for you or for anything else, you know, because the person you're asking about has gone through a big transformation. The transformation may be a good one. That is having some money, having a good family, that transformed themselves. Or this is going to be a bad one, that is an accident or someone's very, very close friend's death or this type of energy. Okay, so the person is really good for you because the person has gone through so many hurdles, so many transformations, so many emotional breakdowns. Okay, and the person is really having their hard time to put themselves together, to bring back that charisma that they had in their past. So that person is really, really helpless right now in this time, and you need to help that person because I'm sensing that the death card also told about some kind of obsession, some kind of addiction. Maybe your person or that person that you're asking about, alcoholic or chain smoker, or you know, drug addicted or anything, you know, anything that can be overworking or overeating or oversleeping or not sleeping at all. So it can be anything. That person is really have some bad habit that has to change, and actually that habit really changed them into a new one, into the good one, okay? Because the person, the death card is representing a new life, a reborn energy. So the person you're asking about has already changed, or in the future they will change only for you, because the person, the before the person and after the transformation, the person is fully different one. So of course the person is good for you, because if they were bad, then they wouldn't transform themselves, okay? Then what else? The Knight of Cups. The Knight of Cups is telling me that that person is really having their high emotional level, okay? They are very emotional. I'm sensing Scorpio. I'm really having that vibe, Scorpio. Scorpio, Pisces, Cancer. The water energy. But I'm really sensing Scorpio, because the death is all about Scorpions. So, you know, very, very emotional person, very intuitive. I'm also getting very knowledgeable, very intuitive. And the person is really coming at your way and going to give you some kind of a proposal, any kind of proposal, okay? Please take what's resonant. And the person is really trying to change themselves only for you. The person is really changing himself or herself for you, because you really value, they really value you a lot. Your person values you a lot. You are everything. You, my pile one viewers, you are that world to them. You are world to them. I'm getting that vibes. You are very, very special to them. Wow. Very passionate, very romantic, and very logical and knowledgeable. They know. They know that pile number one, guys, you're worth it. You have that energy, you have that power to make anything possible. And the way they're changing themselves for you, you're worth it, because they know that pile number ones are the king and queens. They deserve a king and queen to protect them, to love them. And the final card you got, that is Ten of Cups. Wow. Again, water energy, guys. So Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio is really, 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 really going to resonate with you guys. If not, then please choose another pile. Because here I'm getting only water sign, that is Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. They are zodiac, moon, or sunshine, or ascendant, or Venus sign, anything. That is in very, very prominent water vibes. Okay. Ten of Cups is all, you know, emotional fulfillment, wish fulfillment, material fulfillment, the love, the affection, the care. There is responsibility, there is belongingness. The person you are talking about, they are very, very good and right for you, because you worth it, because they want you to love them, and that's why they are changing themselves. So beautiful energy. Yes guys, you got the pile number one. You really chose the perfect person. Beautiful person. That person really changing themselves only for you. Wow. And I'm gonna get some more cards to check their animal spirit. Okay. The deer. Look, the deer energy. That is card number 22. The deer is telling forgiveness. Forgiveness is an act of letting go. Free yourself from pain by releasing negative emotions. What did I tell you guys? What did I tell you? I just told you that this person is super, super, super emotional. They are in their water energy, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, and they had some kind of bad habits or bad addiction or anything that is bad for them, and they understood their bad things after meeting you, and they are trying to change themselves for you so that you can get the queen, king and queen that you deserve. And you need to forgive them. You need to forgive them and letting go, and please let go the negative vibes that doesn't serve you anymore. So, you know, wow, I'm really sensing that some of my viewers, only a little of my viewers, really waiting for their ex-partner to come back. And if you're waiting, then yes, they are really going to come at your door and say sorry to you, and you have to forgive them. And if my viewers don't want your ex, then someone new is really going to come at you and really going to ask for your forgiveness, because I'm sensing you are really, really angry or mad at them because of their bad habits, or they might block you from somewhere, from online media, or they might have, you know, didn't text you, or some kind of this, you know, this situation. Okay, then you got Phoenix. Rebirth. Oh my god, the rebirth. I told you the rebirth card was the first one, that is the death card, and the rebirth is basically Sam, get rid of the past and start afresh. So of course, guys, those of you are really waiting for your ex to come back to you, yes, they are going to come back, and they are really going to change or transform themselves into a new one, so that there won't be any problem. Okay, and you have to get rid of the past, because I know that past doesn't work out, but in the present, in the future, your partner will be in their high level of energy to protect you, to love you, to care you. Oh my god, beautiful vibes, beautiful energy. And look, number 7 and number 22 is really important for you guys. Number 7, number 22, and the owl number is 39. So 3 plus 9 is 12. Number 12 might be important for you. Maybe they have born in December born child or March born child. Okay, let's see. Wow, believe in magic, miracle happening in your life. Miracle is happening in your life, and believe in the magic. What else do you need to hear, guys? Pile number 1, this is your magical pile. Like, believe in the magic. If you're waiting for your husband and just checking that, is that person is your husband or not, then yes, that is your husband. Okay, but you need to wait. Don't take it rush. Okay, you have to wait. You have to believe in the universe, and please pray to your God. And you know, magic and miracle will happen at you. Magic will really, really happening for you, because there is really a powerful attraction is happening. And I'm really sensing today, this is soulmate or twin flame connection, or high level soulmate connection. Beautiful. Believe in the magic. Okay, just believe in the magic. Let's check some cheats. Okay, I got 3. Okay, let's check. The first one is Go, okay, I hope you can see. Go to the right path, you are God. Exactly, try to understand your own power and try to believe your own intuition. If you're thinking that, yes, I'm waiting for my ex, I think he's good for me, then wait. And if you don't think, then don't. Look, stay mute sometimes. Stop talking to the person you are thinking about. Avoid argument. Oh my God. Guys, I really shuffled a lot because I should take the camera here because, you know, this is what my box looks like. Like, look at that. This is where I just shuffled here and take those things here. And oh my God, I can't believe it. So guys, you have to stay mute sometimes and stop talking to the person you are talking or thinking about and avoid arguments. So you're in the right path, but you have to avoid your arguments, your silly arguments that doesn't really necessary to have. Okay, and the next card is, you are confident enough to show your flaws to the world. Exactly. You are confident enough to show your flaws to the world because you have forgive. You have that power of forgiveness. And you already forgive your past person or the person you are thinking about because you want to have a happy life with them. So main question was, is the person that you're thinking, is he or she is good for you? Not, no doubt guys, they are really, really good for you. In fact, I should say that they made for you. So you have to wait, you have to give them time to heal their own energy, own aura to come at you. But yes, they are only for you and they are really, really very good person and they are going through some transformation, some rebirth, some decision-making process. You have to give them some time and they will come at you. You don't have to worry about it. Thank you so much, guys. Pile number one, if you like my video, please give a big thumbs up and like to my channel, subscribe to my channel, like my video, share my video with my friends, and stay with me. Thank you so much. Love ya. Mwah. Hi, my angels. If you choose pile number two, that is the council. So this is your reading and today's question is, the person you are thinking about, is he or she is good for you or not? Okay, so first I'm going to describe the card council. Okay, so I'm really sensing some of my viewers are into spiritual practice, tarot reader or psychic, or love to read tarots, or this is your dream to become a really powerful psychic. Okay, the council card is really telling me that you really believe in your intuition, you love to believe in yourself, in your heart, and in your mind you already know if the person is good for you or not, and you are just here in this video to check it. I'm really sensing that in your heart, in your intuition, you already know that the person is really good for you or bad for you. You were in this video to check that if you are thinking that is true or false. Okay, and the council also tell about that sometimes you need to make some decisions through your intuition, through your heart. Sometimes your mind might say that yes, the person is good for you, but your heart is saying no, the person is not, or vice versa. The heart is telling you that the person is good for you and mind is telling that no, the person is not that good that you are thinking about. So you were in that kind of a conflict situation and you were in this video to check it, that if it's true or not. But the council card 11, it's really, I'm getting the vibe that the person is good for you. Yes, the person is good for you. Good for you, but you need some time to realize that or to have, any physical proof or physical approval, you need to wait sometimes because that person really needs some time, or you really need some time to know or to able to know that the person is good for you or not. Okay, so here you go, the first card, that is the Knight of Wands. The Knight of Wands is really the person you were thinking about, that is a playboy or a playgirl. Okay, they have the energy of a playboyish or playgirlish energy. They are very charming, they are very energetic, they are very courageous, they can do anything you want. So sometimes you are not sure that if they are into that relationship or not, or if they are serious or not, because sometimes this kind of person really happy and really bubbling around you, or sometimes they really get sad and really get confused. So sometimes you really get confused by their dual nature. Okay, and the Knight of Wands is really a kind of a vibe that is really, you know, very courageous, very spontaneous. They don't have any patience. They don't know the word patient, what patience is. They don't know that. They are very impatient, they are very, you know, go-getter. They're always in a hurry to make decision, they're always in a hurry to do things. They are like having always in a rush. So if you're thinking that in you are in a relationship that really going so well, very soon, sooner than you think, sooner than your expectation. So maybe you just met and get in a relationship like in 2 days or 3 days or in a week, and now you're thinking that, oh my god, I started this relationship so early, if the person is good or not, I don't have any idea because I'm so confused. Sometimes they act really cute and sometimes they act really dumb, so I don't know if they're at all serious about this relationship or not. So this is the card, what that means, that yes, you are confused because the person is so intense, so passionate about you, that you sometimes really you know, confused that, oh my god, does he or she really loves me in that way? Because you, in pile number two, you guys think that you are not good enough or you're not pretty enough to get this kind of love in regular basis. Okay, what the next card say? Ooh, the King of Cups, the passionate one, the love one, the emotional master. So the person have both the fiery side, that is Leo, Sagittarius and Aries, and the emotional side, that is Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. So this is very balancing. I'm sensing a twin flame vibes. So pile number two, you guys are very soft spoken, very soft, very emotional, very bubbly, and your person, the person you're thinking about, they are always very fiery, very passionate, they're always in a rush, they're always in a, you know, high level soldier kind of energy, they're always, you know, in a let's go for a long drive in this kind of a vibe. So of course, as long as from this reading, I'm sensing the person is really good for you. The person has a really strong emotional connection for you. They have a soft point for you in their heart, okay? The King of Cups is all about emotional fulfillment, emotional desire, emotional things. So the person really thinks emotionally for you, and the person is highly emotional person, and I know that sometimes they really look unemotional or really look lusty, but trust me guys, this person is really romantic and naughty, and they are a very good lover, or they are a very good friend. If you are thinking about a friend, then of course they are a very good friend. Sometimes you might be confused by their approach, but trust me guys, they are good for you. Just they are thinking and they are doing their work. They don't have patience to think again, okay? They don't have that patience, okay? What's your final card is telling? Let's check. The four of wands. The wands energy is very high. Yes, of course, this is fire energy. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. So four of wands is basically a marriage card. Okay, this is marriage card. This is a kind of completion, finish, or a complete of a cycle, a complete of your fulfilled desire or a fulfillment of your wishes. So four of wands is all about, you know, having a forever kind of relationship. So if you are thinking that if that person is my future spouse, then yes, that is your future spouse. If you're thinking that is that my best friend, yes, that is your best friend, and that is going to last forever. If you're thinking that is it my sister's husband, then that is your sister's husband. So whatever you are thinking about that person, that is yes. And I'm sensing a good forever kind of a friendship with that person. And this person is very, very, very passionate, very energetic, very, very courageous. They don't have time to sit on a place and think about the end night. They are a kind of action oriented person. They love to act. They don't love to sit on a chair and thinking about and planning things out, you know. They are all about, you know, I should do this, you know, I should do that. So they're always into, they might cook you, they might you know, they might cook for you, they might bring food for you or go shopping with you. You know, they are that kind of a person. They don't like to sit in a corner and thinking about their future, just regretting about their past. No, they're kind of a person always moving on one place to another, thinking many things. So very, very courageous and very, very energetic and charming personality. Okay. Wow, exactly. Look, cat energy, independence. As I told you guys that this person is very, very, very independent person. Of course, they are very courageous, they are not dependent to anyone. And this is the card is saying that you are a self-sufficient and sovereign being. You don't need to depend on anything or anyone else to achieve happiness in your life. So that has two messages for you, that the person you are thinking about, yes, the person is very independent, they are self-sufficient, they know how to happy themselves, they know how to be how to lead a good, happy, healthy life, and they will provide you everything and they will not want anything from you. If you're thinking that that person is really lusty, they're really greedy, they want something from you, so you are really wrong. No, that person is really independent and they achieve their own happiness in their own worth. They don't need anything of yours. They just need, you know, support, or I should say that you need them. They don't need you. Okay, they are really, really independent. They're independent, and the cat energy is really telling me that these persons are really highly spiritual, because cat energy is very, very spiritual. Wow, and they are born healer. They are born healer. They heal themselves very faster. They heal others very fast. Wow, beautiful, beautiful person. Who you were thinking about? Pile number two. The next card is harmony. Wow, look, harmony. So well energy is you singing and music to harmonize your vibration and tune yourself. So of course this person has a very independent kind of energy, and that person might love singing or music or dancing, or they really love to vibrate their energy into higher and to make themselves more, you know, positive and energetic. This person is really into themselves. They don't give a shit about others. They're really happy with themselves. And the card number five is really coming out. There is five. And card number five. What is card number five? The card number five is all about traveling to the world. The card number 5 is all about adventure, changing. They love changes. They have natural capability of adaptability. They can adapt any place. Okay? They can really change themselves through the situation. Wow. Beautiful, beautiful person. Beautiful person. They are so good for you. I mean, you should need them. Okay, you should need them because they have such a high vibrational energy. Because they are so independent. Okay. What the protection message? Oh my God. You are transforming. You are in a cocoon. Be ready to burn like a butterfly. This card really came in the pile number 1. Okay. So that person is really transforming, and my pile number 2 viewers, you guys are also transforming. There is another card that is showing that, wow, it's time to enjoy and rejuvenate your energy. Be greeny, fresh, and refill your energy. That is really exactly same, like harmonize yourself, singing, dancing, and okay. So, you know, the person you're thinking about, the person you're talking, that if the person is good for you or bad, the person is really, really, really good for you, because the person is really independent. They take care of themselves and they love all people they meet. And actually, they are very, very frank. They are some kind of a flirty and courageous, but at the same time, they are very loyal. And they're not a cheater. They are so independent, and they value others' independence too. They will give you full freedom. So I got 3 cheats for you guys. So the first cheat is lucky time, win-win situation. What else do you need to hear? This person is so good for you. Lucky time. Oh my God, they're so good for you. Okay, so no, why no? The why the no card is here. Okay, I'm gonna take why the no card is here. Okay, let's take one more card. The card is here. Why the no card is here. Go to the right path. You are God. So basically, you are on the right path, but you are thinking that you are not in a right path. So maybe you are thinking of turning your way back to them. So don't do that. The no card is here because don't do that. Don't do that. Don't. Good news. Something unexpectedly good things are coming at you. And look, lucky time, win-win situation. And some good news, something unexpectedly good things are coming at you. What else do you need to hear, guys? Wow, beautiful energies. This is a time to rejuvenate yourself, to take time to refill your energy. And the person you're thinking about, the person is really, 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 really positive for you. So go for it. Thank you so much, pile number 2. If you like my video, please like my video, give it a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and wait for my next video. Thank you so much. Mwah.